Hello everyone, myself Bisni Pisharian, Assistant Professor at Suresh Gyanviha University. Today I'm going to discuss about the bioinformatics, means the uses of the bioinformatics in the new drug discovery. Learning objectives of this topic. This lesson will help the students to understand the bioinformatics, uses of the bioinformatics in the new drug discovery. And the outcomes after this lesson, students will be able to describe the new drug discovery, how we can do the discovery of a new drug with the help of the bioinformatics. So in the previous class, I have discussed about the what is bioinformatics, what is the need of the bioinformatics, and some applications of the bioinformatics. So the bioinformatics is an interdisciplinary field that develops method and the software tools for the understanding biological data. Okay, for understanding the biological data, this bioinformatics develop some tools and the means develops some software tools and the methods for understanding the biological data. Means there are lots of biological data are available. Okay, so for understanding each and every biological data, this bioinformatics developed or create a method or a software tool. As an interdisciplinary field of the science, bioinformatics combines biology, computer science, information engineering, mathematics, and the statistics to analyze and interpret the biological data. Okay, because this bioinformatics is an interdisciplinary field. Okay, so this bioinformatics combines biology, computer science, information engineering, mathematics, and the statistics. So these all subject altogether makes the bioinformatics. Okay, without these subject, bioinformatics doesn't make any sense. So this bioinformatics combines or the combination of some biology, computer science, information engineering, statistics, and the mathematics is known as bioinformatics. So we can say bioinformatics is the combination of biological data and the some informatics. Okay, so we can say this is the combination of the computer science and the informatics. Okay, so this is the bioinformatics. Why we are combining all these subjects together? To analyze and interpret the biological data. Okay, for the main purpose of combining all the subject together to make the bioinformatics. Okay, so the main purpose is to analyze and interpret the biological data. So this bioinformatics is the interdisciplinary field that developed the method and the software tools for the understanding the biological data. How we can understand the biological data? By analyzing, by interpreting the data, by combination of the biology, computer science, information engineering, mathematics, and the statistics subject all together is known as the bioinformatics. Bioinformatics has been used for in silico. So I have discussed about this in silico. So in silico means that is performed on the computer. Okay, so all the things, all the data, all the interpretation, all the analysis, all the things we are doing on the computer in the bioinformatics, because this is a combination of informatics and the computer science. So we are using the computer application of the bioinformatics. Without the use of the computer, we can't do any bioinformatic data analysis and all. So with the help of the computer only, we can do all the bioinformatics. So in the name itself, bio plus informatics. Okay, so the combination of the computer science and the informatics. Okay, so this is the bioinformatics. So the bioinformatics has been used for in silico. Okay, in silico, you have to remember that in silico means the performed on the computer or via computer simulation. So this is used in silico analysis of biological queries using mathematical and the statistical techniques. So this bioinformatics analysis of biological queries, okay, well, there are lots of queries regarding the biological data. So that all the analysis of the biological query, okay, that we are doing with the help of the bioinformatics by using the mathematical and the statistical techniques. So need of the bioinformatics. So the need of the bioinformatics has arisen from the recent explosion of publicly available genomic information. Okay, So the need of the bioinformatics has arisen from the recently this need, the need of the bioinformatics has been arisen, and that is because of the publicly available genomic information, such as that resulting from the Human Genome Project. Then second point is gain a better understanding of gene analysis, taxonomy, and the evolution. Okay, with the help of the bioinformatics, we can understand properly the gene analysis, taxonomy, and evolution. Then next is to work efficiently on rational drug design and reduce the drug development duration or the time. Okay, so the need of the bioinformatics, third point, is to work efficiently. Okay, we can work efficiently with the help of this bioinformatics, as well as this bioinformatics reduce the drug development duration. Okay, duration of the drug development is reduced, or okay, we can decrease with the help of the bioinformatics. Without the bioinformatics, we need more time to develop a drug. But with the help of the bioinformatics, that time will be reduced. The processes of designing a new drug using bioinformatic tools have opened a new area of the research. Okay, with the help of the bioinformatics, we can design a new drug, and this is a new area of the research. However, computational techniques assist one in searching drug target and in designing drug in silico. Okay, so the computational technique assists in searching the drug target. Okay, for finding a new drug, we have to target a drug, we have to target a disease also. So all the searching of the drug target and designing the drug in silico, but it takes long time and the money. Okay, it takes long time as well as it takes more money also. In order to design a new drug, one need to follow the following path. Okay, so for designing a new drug, we are discussing in today's class how we can design a new drug, means how we can do the new drug development. So this is the main topic of today's class. So let's see the steps of designing a new drug. Okay, for new drug development, okay, for the new drug development, we have to first identify the target disease. Okay, without identification of the target disease, we can't find out any new drug. So first step of the new drug development is to identify the target disease. Okay, after identifying the target disease, we have to study the interesting compound. Okay, we have to study the interesting compound, means that compound that reduce that particular disease. Okay, and that inhibit the symptoms of that particular disease. We have to find out some interesting compounds. Okay, that must be related to that disease also. Third point is detection of the molecular basis for disease rational drug design technique. Okay, we have to detect the rational drug design technique. Next is refinement of the compounds. Okay, next step of the new drug development is refinement of the compounds. Next step is quantitative structure activity relationship. Okay, so this quantitative structure activity relationship is means which group of particular drug is responsible for the particular pharmacological action, we can find out with the help of the structure activity relationship. And solubility of the molecule. Okay, next is we have to find out the solubility of the particular molecule. Okay, last step is drug testing. Okay, we have to test that identified drug, means the new drug. So first step of the new drug development is identification of the target disease. Next is we have to study the interesting compound. Okay, next is detection of the molecular basis for disease rational drug design technique. Next is refinement of the compounds, quantitative structure activity relationship, solubility of the molecule, and the drug testing. So these are the steps we have to follow while we are doing any new drug development. So first step, identify the target disease. How we can identify the target disease? Okay, so one needs to know all about the disease and existing or the traditional remedies. Okay, so we have to target one disease. Okay, after that we have to gain all the information about that particular disease. Okay, we have the knowledge, or the researcher or the scientist must have the knowledge about that particular disease. Okay, and also he or she must have the existing or the traditional remedies, means the existing or traditional treatment of the particular disease. Okay, so the scientist or the researchers must have the knowledge of all the knowledge of about that particular disease. Okay, and must know all the existing as well as traditional treatment of that disease. Okay, it is also important to look at very similar afflictions and their known treatments. Okay, so similar afflictions means the particular, we have identified one disease or we targeted one disease. Okay, so similar means some similar afflictions also there. So we have to know all that disease that is similar to that targeted disease, and as well as we have to know all the treatment of that similar afflictions also. So first we have to target one disease. Okay, after that we have to gain all the knowledge about that particular disease. Okay, after that we have to gain the knowledge about existing as well as traditional remedies or the treatment of the particular disease. Okay, and there are lots of similar diseases are there. Okay, there are lots of similar diseases are there. We have to gain all the knowledge about that, about the similar diseases as well as their treatment also. So this is the first step of new drug development. Target identification alone is not sufficient. Okay, so target identification is not sufficient in order to achieve a successful treatment of a disease. Okay, so target identification is not sufficient in order to achieve a successful treatment of a disease. A real drug need to be developed. Okay, so we have to develop a real drug that shows the pharmacological action against that particular disease. So that is the successful treatment of a disease. Okay, so identifying the target disease is the first step of the new drug discovery. Once one needs to know all the information about that particular disease, means all the etiology or the pathophysiology or the existing or traditional remedies, okay, all the treatment, okay, that is existing or that may be traditional remedies, we have to know all the information about that particular disease. And it is also important to look at very similar affiliation and their treatment also, means similar diseases are there. Okay, related diseases are there. We have to know all the treatment of that related disease as well as all the knowledge about that particular similar diseases. And target identification is not sufficient in order to achieve a successful treatment. We already know that, because targeting is not a successful treatment of a disease. We have to find out a real drug that exert a pharmacological action against that particular disease. So that is the successful treatment of a disease. This drug must influence the target protein in such a way that it does not interfere with the normal metabolism. Okay, once we have developed a new drug, okay, that drug must influence the target protein. Okay, that identified or developed drug that must influence the target protein in such a way that it does not interfere with the normal metabolism. Okay, the particular drug doesn't interfere with the normal metabolism. Okay, but that influences the target protein. Okay, so the developed drug must influence the target protein in such a way that it does not interfere with the normal metabolism. Okay, bioinformatics methods have been developed to virtually screen the target of the compounds that bind and inhibit the protein. Okay, so the bioinformatic methods. Okay, there are bioinformatic methods are developed. Okay, that is for what purpose? For targeting the compounds that bind and inhibit the protein but not interfere the normal metabolism. Okay, so this is the use of the bioinformatics. Okay, so what the bioinformatics do? Bioinformatics methods have been developed for finding out the for screening the target of the compound that bind and inhibit the protein but doesn't interfere with the normal metabolism. That is the main thing of new drug discovery or new drug development, that particular identified drug doesn't interfere with the normal metabolism, but the drug must be target to the protein and bind with that protein and inhibit the protein. So this is the main thing while we are doing a new drug development. So this is the first step, identification of the target disease. Then next is studying interesting compounds. How we can study the interesting compounds? Means one needs to identify and study the lead compounds that have some activity against a targeted disease. Okay, so we have identified one particular disease. Okay, after the identification of the particular disease, we have to find out or we have to identify and study the lead compounds. That lead compound must show the action against a disease, against that targeted disease. Means we have identified one disease and that lead compound should have some activity against that particular identified disease. Okay, so that is the lead compound. That means the lead compound must show some little bit action against that particular means identified disease. These may be only marginally useful and may have severe side effects. Okay, so that lead compound may be only the marginal use, means maybe only 1% that is useful and shows lots of side effects that doesn't affect. Means with the help of the bioinformatics, we can find out, we can reduce the side effect and we can increase the therapeutic effect also by changing the structure or by refinement method. We can do all the things, but that lead compound means we have to find out the lead compound that shows some, means it 1% of the action against that disease. Okay, so this is the main thing. So that is the second point, studying the interesting compound. We have to find it, we have to identify the lead compound that must show at least 1% of the pharmacological action against that particular identified disease. And that if that particular drug shows many of the side effects, or if that shows only 1% of the action against that disease, that doesn't affect, we can change all the things. Okay, with the help of the bioinformatics, with the help of the, by changing the structure also, we can increase the therapeutic action and decreases the side effects. So that this is the main technology. Okay, we can change all the things with the help of the bioinformatics. These compounds provide a starting point for refinement of the chemical structure. Okay, so this studying the interesting compound is the starting point for refinement of the chemical structure. Okay, we can change the chemical structure according to their action and all. Okay, if any drug shows the lots of side effects because of if that particular structure containing any alcohol group, we can change the alcohol group and we can add any amine group in that particular structure. Okay, so we can do all the things with the help of the bioinformatics. So first we have to identify the target disease. Okay, after that, we have to identify the lead compound that shows, that should at least show 1% of the activity against that identified disease. Okay, and this compound provides a starting point for the refinement of the chemical structure. So this is the second point of the new drug development. Next is detect the molecular basis for disease. कि इफ इट इज नोन दैट अ ड्रग मस्ट बाइंड टू अ पर्टिकुलर स्पॉट ऑन ए पर्टिकुलर प्रोटीन और न्यूक्लियोटाइड देन अ ड्रग कैन बी अ टेलर मेड टू बाइंड एट दैट साइट ओके सो वी हैव आइडेंटिफाइड दैट लीड कंपाउंड ओके सो If we can know that the drug must bind to a particular spot on a particular protein, okay, if we know that, okay, so that can be tailor-made to bind at that site, okay. So if we know the, all the things, that is very useful. This is often moduled computationally using any of the several different techniques. Okay, so this binding to the protein and all the things, that is often moduled computationally using any of the several techniques. So first is traditionally the primary way of determining that what compound would be tested computationally was provided by the researchers' understanding of the molecular interaction. So the researchers, what they do, they first understand the molecular interaction. Okay, so that is the traditional method. Primary way of determining what compound would be tested computationally was provided by the researchers. Okay, which compound we have to computationally test it, that is provided by the researchers. Okay, and that researchers, they understand the molecular interaction. Second method, this is the traditional method. Okay, second method is that brute force testing for the large number of the compounds from a database of available structure. Okay, so next method is we have to find out the compound from the large number of the database of available structures. Okay, so there are lots of databases are there. Okay, so we have to find out the structure database. Okay, we have to find out the structure database, and after that we have to test all the structure compounds. So these are the two methods. First one is traditional method. In that traditional method, the researchers provide the compounds that would be tested computationally. Okay. And second method is we have to find out the compound from the database of available structures. Next is rational drug design technique. Okay, rational drug design techniques tab. These techniques attempts to reproduce the researchers' understanding of how to choose likely compounds built into a software package that is capable of modeling a very large number of compounds in an automated way. Okay. So the rational drug design techniques, these techniques attempts to reproduce the researchers' understanding of how to choose the likely compound. Okay, so this is the method to choose likely compounds. Okay, built into a software package that is capable of modeling a very large number of the compound in an automated way. So with the help of this technique, okay, we can find out a particular drug by using some software, okay, in automated way. Okay, many different algorithms have been used for this type of testing, many of which were adapted from artificial intelligence applications. Okay, so there are lots of algorithms have been used for this type of the testing, okay, means automated testing, and many of which were adapted from the artificial intelligence applications. The complexity of biological system makes it very difficult to determine the structure of large biomolecules. Okay, so the biological system is very complex. Okay, biological system is very complex, and the complexity of the biological system makes it very difficult to determine the structure of large molecules. Okay, so we can't find out the structure of the large biomolecules because this biological system is very complex. Okay, so ideally experimentally determined structure is desired, means through the X-ray or through the NMR we can find out the structure, okay, we can find out the structure. So that is designed, but biomolecules are very difficult to crystallize. Okay, so biomolecule is very difficult to crystallize because this biological system is very complex, and the large biomolecule structure we can't find, means that is very difficult to determine the structure of the large molecules. And we can do that with the help of the X-ray and the NMR. Okay, with the help of the X-ray and the NMR, we can design one structure. Okay, but the crystallization of the biomolecule is very difficult. Next is refinement of the compounds. Okay, so once you got the number of lead compounds have been found, the computational laboratory techniques have been very successful in refining the molecular structure to give a greater drug activity and fewer side effect. So what is the refinement of the compound means? So we have found one lead compound, okay, and that only shows the 1% of pharmacological activity against that disease. Okay, only 1%. So we have to modify that compound. Okay, we have to modify that compound in order to achieve a greater drug activity or greater pharmacological action and fewer the side effects. Okay, so we have to modify that particular compound by addition or by removing any group from that particular compound, or we can add the any group to achieve the pharmacological action and means decreasing the side effect and also. So refinement means the modification. Okay, we can modify the structure according to the side effects and according to the pharmacological action and all. Okay, so once you got the number of lead compounds, okay, computational and laboratory techniques, okay, computational and the laboratory techniques have been very successful in refining the compound. Okay, so for refining the refinement of the compound, we need computational technique as well as the laboratory techniques. Okay, with the help of these two techniques, we can refine the molecular structure. Okay, we can refine the molecular structure to give a greater drug activity and the fewer side effect. Okay, so for refinement of the compound, we need computational techniques as well as the laboratory techniques. Okay, with this combination gives greater drug activity. We can, with the help of this combination techniques, we can refine the molecular structure to achieve the good pharmacological action and fewer side effects. Done both in the laboratory and the computationally by examining the molecular structure to determine which aspects are responsible for both the drug activity and the side effect. Okay, in the laboratory and in the computational techniques, we can find out which group is responsible for that particular pharmacological action and which group is responsible for the side effects. Okay, so that we can find out. Okay, so if we are talking about any antihistaminic drugs, okay, so in the antihistaminic drugs, all the first generation H1 antagonist, okay, all the first generation H1 antagonist shows some drowsiness or some sedative action. Why? Because that all the H1 antagonist drug penetrate to the CNS. Okay, so that is because of that. Means the all the drug, they penetrate into the CNS. Because of that, H1 antagonist, all the first generation H1 antagonist shows the sedation side effect as well as the drowsiness. But when we are talking about this second generation H1 antagonist, okay, second generation antagonist, H1 antagonist, they couldn't penetrate into the CNS. Okay, means they can't penetrate into the CNS. Because of that only, the second generation H1 antagonist doesn't show any drowsiness or any sedation. So the second generation H1 antagonist is widely used. Okay, so the first generation So that is the thing. Okay, that is the thing. Here, these all the things we can determine in the laboratory and the computational techniques. Okay, so this is the thing. And for showing the antihistaminic activity, there are some classification, means there are some groups are present, means one amino group. Okay, one amino group with two methyl group is compulsory for showing the antihistaminic activity, as well as and one amino group is attached with the two phenyl group or aromatic group for showing the antihistaminic activity, and that two amino group is connected with a ethyl group. So that structure, okay, that structure is responsible for the antihistaminic activity. For showing any of the antihistaminic activity, the structure or the drug should have one ethyl group, one amino group that should be attached with methyl group, and one another amino group that should be attached with two aromatic groups. So these are the drug activity, means that all the things are responsible for the pharmacological action as well as the side effects. So this is the thing. This is the refinement of the compound we can do with the help of the bioinformatics. Next is quantitative structure activity relationship, QSAR. Okay, so this structure activity relationship is very important in the medicinal chemistry. All the structure activity relationship we can learn in the medicinal chemistry. Computational technique should be used to detect the functional group in your compound in order to refine your drug. Okay, so for refining the drug, we have to use the computational technique. Okay, with the help of the computational technique, we can find out which group is responsible for the pharmacological action and which group is responsible for the side effects. We can find out through the computational techniques. QSAR consists of computing every possible number that can describe a molecule. Okay, so the QSAR, Q as a quantitative structure activity relationship, consists of computing every possible number that can describe a molecule. Okay, so QSAR means a molecule is means described in well manner. Okay, so that is only possible in the QSAR. Then doing an enormous curve fit to find out which aspect of the molecule correlate well with the drug activity or the side effect severity. Okay, so this is I have discussed in the previous step. Okay, I have taken one example, antihistaminic activity. Okay, so that is the thing in the quantitative structure relationship. Every drug have their own specific groups that is responsible for the pharmacological action, and some groups are also there that is responsible for the side effect of the drug. Okay, so that is coming under the structure activity relationship. We can find out which group of that particular structure is responsible for the particular activity. Okay, and we can refine, we can change, we can modify that drug according to our need. Okay, if any drug shows more side effect and less pharmacological action, okay, so we can change the group in that particular drug, and we can change the pharmacological action, and we can decrease the side effect. So this is the thing coming under the quantitative structure activity relationship. This information can then be used to suggest new chemical modification for synthesis and the testing. Okay, after refinement of the compound, we have to find out how we can synthesize that particular compound. Okay, and how we can test that particular compound. Okay, we have to find out the synthesis, and we have to find out the testing or method of that particular compound after refinement. Okay, after refinement also we have to find out the synthesis and we have to find out the testing also. Next is solubility of the molecule. Okay, for new drug development we have to find out the solubility of the molecule, because the solubility of the molecule is most important factor for showing any pharmacological action, for showing means less side effect and all the thing. The solubility is very, very important. So there are water soluble drugs are there and water insoluble drugs are there. So water soluble is hydrophilic, what means, and lipid soluble drug is also there. So that is known as hydrophobic drug. So one need to check whether the target molecule is water soluble or readily soluble in fatty tissue will affect what part of the body it becomes concentrated in. Okay, so the solubility of the drug is most important thing. Okay, important thing means which part of the body is diseased. Okay, according to that we have to develop a drug. Okay, so water soluble drugs are there, water insoluble drugs are there. Okay, so the drug must be water hydrophilic as well as the hydrophobic drug, means lipid soluble also, because without lipid solubility the drug doesn't penetrate through the membrane and that doesn't show any pharmacological action for the absorption, for the metabolism, for the excretion, all the things. The drug should be water soluble and hydrophobic also. The ability to get a drug to the correct part of the body is an important factor in its potency. So the ability to get a drug to the correct part of the body is an important factor in its potency. Third is, ideally there is a continual exchange of information between the researchers doing QSAR studies, synthesis and the testing. Okay, so we can modify the solubility of the drug according to the disease. Okay, so with the help of the QSAR we can modify the solubility also, we can synthesis and we can test all that drug. Okay, these techniques are frequently used and often very successful since they do not rely on knowing the biological basis of the disease, which can be very difficult to determine. So knowing the biological basis of the disease, that is very difficult to determine, and these techniques are frequently used and often very successful also. Okay, so this is the solubility. Solubility is the most important factor in new drug development. Next is drug testing. Okay, once a drug has been shown to be effective by an initial assay techniques, much more testing must be done before it can be given to the human patient. Okay, before giving to the human patient, the clinical trial must be there. Okay, without the clinical trial, that particular drug we can't administer to the human patient. So once a drug has been shown to be effective by an initial assay techniques, that should be undergo in the clinical trial before it given to the human patient. Animal testing is the primary type of the testing at this stage. Okay, animal testing is compulsory. Eventually, the compounds which are deemed suitable at this stage are sent on to the clinical trial. Okay, so after testing on the animals, that particular compounds that are suitable at this stage, that are sent to the clinical trial. Okay, so before administration to the human patient, that particular drug or the identified drug must go to some more testers. Okay, testings, and that animal testing is the primary type of the testing. If any drug passes on the animal testing, that should undergo in the clinical trial. In the clinical trials, additional side effects may be found and human dosages are determined. Okay, so in the clinical trials, additional side effects may be found. Okay, so this is the clinical trial. This is the last step of the approval of the drug. So in the clinical trial, the additional side effects may be found and human dosage are determined. The clinical trial itself, the human dosages are determined. Means which type of the route we have to choose, which how much milligram of the drug we have to take at once a day, or we how much milligram of the drug we can take. Okay, so that all the things we have to find out in the clinical trial itself. Okay, so the clinical trial is the last step of the new drug development. Okay, so if any drug passes in the clinical trial, that comes in the market and that easily administered to the patient. So these are the steps of new drug development. So once again, we can see the steps. First, we have to identify the disease. Sorry, we have to identify the target disease. Okay, after identifying the target disease, we have to find out the lead compound. Okay, and that lead compound at least show 1% of the pharmacological action against that disease. Okay, and that may be marginally useful, and that may show lots of side effects. Okay, and that we can overcome with the help of the refinement of the compound, all the things. So we have to first find out the target disease. After that, we have find out the lead compound that show at least 1% of the pharmacological action against that identified targeted disease. Then detect the molecular basis for the disease. Next step is rational drug design techniques. Okay, rational drug design technique. Next is refinement of the compound. Refinement of the compound is the thing we can modify that particular lead compound to achieve the good pharmacological action and to get fewer side effects. Okay. So this refinement of the drug we can do in the laboratory and the computational combining method. Okay, the combination of the laboratory techniques and the computational techniques that determine the drug activity and the side effect of the particular lead compound. Next is quantitative structure activity relationship. Okay, we can find out which group of that particular lead compound is responsible for the pharmacological action and which group is responsible for the side effect, and we can change accordingly. Okay, we can change accordingly. If the drug show more side effect, we can change the particular group. Okay, and all the things we can do with the help of the bioinformatics, which means we can do with the help of the computer, with the help of the software also. Next is we have to find out the solubility of the molecule. Okay, so finding out the solubility of the molecule is very, very important for the absorption of the drug, for the elimination, for the metabolism. The solubility is more important thing. So one need to check whether the target molecule is water soluble or readily soluble in the fatty tissue. Okay, so that is the main thing to find out. Next is drug testing. So once a drug has shown been effective in initial assay technique, that must undergo some other testing also. Okay, so animal testing is the primary type of the testing. If any drug passes on the animal testing, that compound undergoes to the clinical trial. Okay, in the clinical trial is the last step of the new drug development. Okay, additional side effects may be found in that clinical trial and human dosages we can determine. Okay, so if the drug passes in the clinical trials, that drug comes in the market and we can easily give to the, or we can easily administer to the patient. So these all are about the new drug discovery with the help of the bioinformatics. Let's see some MCQs. The laboratory work using computers and associated with web-based analysis, generally online, is referred to as wet lab. The correct answer is wet lab. Next is the computer simulation refers to in silico. Computer simulation refers to in silico. Next question is the stepwise method for solving problems in computer science is called algorithm. The stepwise method for solving the problems in the computer science is known as algorithm. Next question is, which of the following are not the application of the bioinformatics? So drug designing, data storage and the management, understand the relationship between the organisms, none of the above. So the correct answer is none of the above. The computational methodology that tries to find the best matching between two molecules or receptors and the ligands are called molecular docking. The correct answer is molecular docking. And so this is all about the new drug development with the help of the bioinformatics. And this is the reference. So I hope everybody understood it very well. So thank you.